in a family, you can have a light skin member and a dark skin based on their genetics. So you see in some families, like if you have a mixed family, you'll see one child comes out very light skin and another child comes out dark skin. The Prophet ﷺ said, "An-nasu kulluhum banu Adam." All of humanity are from the tribe of Adam. So this literally erases this whole idea that we have these distinct races out there. We're all of the same tribe. We're just from different branches of the same tribe. And just like you have in a family, you can have a light skin member and a dark skin based on their genetics. So you see in some families, like if you have a mixed family, you'll see one child comes out very light skin and another child comes out dark skin. And so Adam and Hawa, which are the original two people that we all come from, and this is our material sciences have also indicated this. Adam and Hawa, the word Adam is most likely, I mean the Hebrew derivation is different from ours, but most likely is from Udmat al-Ard, which is the topsoil of the earth. And the Prophet ﷺ said that Adam was created from all the topsoil of the earth, the white soil, the black soil, the brown soil, the yellow soil, the red soil. So you see all of these soils come out in the children of Adam. And according to Surah Ar-Rum, this is a sign that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has made in your tongues and in your complexions. These are signs for people who know. So Allah has diversified creation as signs of His power. So we celebrate these differences, but we recognize that all you have to do is cut the skin and you get red blood, that we all bleed red. So we're essentially the same people. We're from the same tribe. And this is the universality of Islam. وَآدَمُ مِنْ تُرَابٍ. And then he said, Adam is from Turab. In other words, the materiality of Adam is from Turab. So his physical body, the physical makeup that we all share is earth. And that should make us humble. But the spiritual nature is what distinguishes us. We're not distinguished by our materiality. We're distinguished by our spirituality. And that's why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, "Inna akramakum 'indallahi atqakum," that the most honored and noble of you in God's eyes, not in people's eyes, in God's eyes, are the most pious, the most dutiful, the most conscientious, the people that strive to perfect their souls.